everybody. Welcome back to Sharpest Entertainment. Hope everybody's having a blessed day. Have a good day. Today we're going to talk about people that think they're slick and they have bad intentions from the beginning. We're going to call it the beware the handshake that hides a snake. Okay. So basically, when you're growing up on the streets and then you become a criminal and you end up going to jail and everything like that, a lot of criminals, they learn, once they hit prison, they learn how to do manipulation and stuff like that, and they learn how to use people, you know, which is a trip, you know. And you see a lot of that. You see a lot of that in the prison system. And I got to witness it out here in the real world a few times. And it's funny because let me tell the story of inside. You know, there was this dude before I paroled from Ironwood. There was this dude, I told a story about him a while back, about you never know when your enemy could be your friend. I think the video is still up. Well, this dude moved in my cell, but before he moved in my cell, I had barely got to the yard. I wasn't on the yard that long, maybe about a month, if that. And nobody knew I tattooed, nobody knew that I would draw. Nobody knew nothing really about me. I was pretty much to myself and only talked to very limited people. Well, this guy was celled up with another dude from the area. And this dude used to go to Star big. He used to go to Star Max Draw Plus. He would go with somebody else, you know? So the dude that was living with the guy that went Max Draw and all that stuff that was living large, he came and told me, hey man, my cellie had just left. He had just moved out to another building. And he came up to me, he's like, hey, I want to move in with you. Can I move in with you? I'm not really feeling where I'm at. And in my mind, I was thinking, like, dang, like that fool's over there eating large, eating big, you know? And he wants to move in with my broke ass. Like, you don't even know me really like that. But I had talked to him a few times, not a whole lot. I had talked to him, you know, here and there through crossing and chopped it up, but we weren't real tight, we weren't real cool. So I ended up moving him in, you know. And when he moved in, we got to talking, and he told me, he's like, man, I just couldn't. He's like, yeah, I was living large over there, I was eating good, everything was straight, but I just couldn't trust him. When if something went down, I didn't really feel like he was there 100%, like if something happened, you know. And I gotta be celled up with somebody that I could feel comfortable with if something's going down, something goes down. So like, all right, that's understandable, you know? So we end up hitting it off. We end up being really, really cool. And I started hustling drawings and stuff like that. And he was doing his little hustle. And we ended up he ended up pulling a free staff, and we were getting tobacco and we were making money off tobacco and all that, and everything was good. And then I finally told him one day, like, hey, like, I tattoo. It was after about a month or 2 years in the cell, and he's like, what? He's like, oh, that's cool. I said, well, I'm gonna hook you up, you know. Then he thought I was gonna do like some little thing on a little piece on him. Well, I ended up doing his whole back because his character was good, you know. I he was a genuine individual, you know, really good people. So he didn't have them, he wasn't a snake like that, you know? And you see plenty of them in there. And I come out to the real world, and I'm talking to somebody, and everything's going cool, you know? Everything's cool, and he's asking me questions about institutions and just a bunch of, like, conversations, you know? Which wasn't really... I didn't really trip on it too much. And then one day he's telling me how he's gonna do something to make this person happen, because in return he wants to work his way to get something out of that person. So like, I didn't really trip on it. Like, yeah, that's a typical manipulation, typical stuff that I've seen before, but I didn't really trip on it too much, you know. Time had passed, and then he found an interest in something that I liked, and then started talking about that more, and we started talking about it more and more, and then I asked for advice one time, gave me some advice, and everything was going good. He helped me out in a little situation. It was good. And then he asked me for something. He asked me for something simple that I couldn't really take care of at the moment. My hands were pretty much tied at that moment, so I couldn't fulfill his need. And after that, he never talked to me again. He ghosted me. So it made me think, was it all a power play? Was it all something that he was looking to do intentionally to try to benefit for himself? Or did it just really piss him off that much because I couldn't fulfill his need one time? But he never took the time to understand why I couldn't fulfill his need at that one time, how I couldn't help him in that particular moment. So I just got to thinking, like, dang, that's a... Some people, they read these books like the 48 Laws of Power, and they learn these little tactics and they try to use them. But when you try to use them type of tactics, the way I was seeing that it was being used, because it was playing out over a little bit of time, you can't use them on somebody that's fully aware of what's going on in the situations. You know, stuff like that doesn't get you far. And I see a lot of that on YouTube, and a lot of these content creators, they're doing that, you know? They're using these little tactics to try to get over on people, try to get over on supporters, and stuff like that, you know? A red flag to me is when people call their supporters and subscribers, or people just in general looking for advice or whatever, when they call them fans, like... that's a red flag to me right away, you know? Or they try to put too much emphasis on it about, I love you guys, and they just do too much. We're a family, just this and that. They don't really know the subscribers, the viewers, to that extent to put that much into it, you know? Yeah, there's be thankful for the people viewing, be thankful for all that, be thankful for the subscribers. Yeah, that's fine, be thankful. But when you start calling them fans and other words like the gang and this and that, and just way out stuff, it's just really strange to me, you know. And I see a different motive behind it, but a lot of people, they don't see that. Like today I was hearing somebody, they were talking, and it's like, oh no, don't give them that, get paid for that. Like, basically they're gonna talk about something, and then he stopped them from talking about it so he can make a whole other video about it to get paid behind it. Like, you already in the conversation, just speak on it, just talk about it, don't try to make a whole different other profit off of it, you know. It's all, I'm telling you, a lot of these content creators are all about clicks and views and likes these days, and they're running drag on a lot of people, and it's, I could see it, you know. I'm pretty sure a lot of the viewers can see it, you know, but it is what it is. Just remember, man, beware of the handshake that hides a snake, man. Some people have some crazy alternative motives. You just got to be careful for it, man. With that being said, I'm out. This is my video for today. Hope everybody has a blessed day. Remember, always stay sharp, man. Always stay humble and remain positive at all times. Stay uncommon amongst common people. the world is your playground, go play in it. But we said, I'm out. Peace.